What's up, everybody? Good morning, good morning, good morning. Let's go. Hey. Today we are going to talk about bringing in abundance and prosperity into your life. If I am talking a little bit funny today, forgive me. I am closing up my gap using the rubber band method. We'll talk about that in another video. But let's talk about abundance and prosperity. For a lot of you guys who don't know, I don't tell a lot about my story, but a year and a half ago, I was at rock bottom. A lot was going on and I was at rock bottom and I decided to make some changes. A lot of things that I'm going to speak to you about, I hope that maybe, you know, if you have an experience or you're going through things, that maybe this could help you along your journey. I've learned that when it comes to abundance, prosperity, you know, bringing that kind of like getting your swag back. I don't know. It's a lot of things that you could say, but as far as trying to bring more abundance and prosperity in your life, you know, blessing the home and doing things like that, there are some very specific things that I do. As of right now, you know, I am in day 4 of this detox. So I'm grateful for you guys. Thank you so much for everyone who has joined that challenge. You know, again, you know, you want to detox a lot of things and you want to, for the most part, detox negative thinking. Negative thinking will put you in a place where you're not able to get that abundance you need. So with that being said, let me show you some of the wonderful things that I do to help me along my journey. So first, we're going to start off with this lovely candle here. As you know, go for the honey, green for the money. So this is my green candle, which represents money. What I have done is I've taken the candle and I've poked 4 long holes in there. And usually how I do this is probably a little bit weird, but when I'm done burning the incense, the little stick that's left, I just kind of use that to poke the hole in. So this is my green candle to bring in money. We will talk about a few things that I dress the candle with. And of course, the biggest thing of doing candle magic or doing a 7-day candle to bring in some type of, something into your life, you want to have the intention set. You want to feel it. You want to be in that place. You want to you kind of be in that vibe. You know what I'm saying? So the first thing I do is, you know, usually the candles come with like stickers and stuff. I take them off. I use hot water and get off the residual and I clean it up to make sure there is nothing on here that needs to be on here. Second thing I do is I use my Florida water. A lot of people use a green one. I prefer this one. It's just a little cleaner to me. And I do use this on a daily basis on my skin. And I bless the candle. Or should I say anoint or clean it in a sense? I'm cleaning it. So I'm using Upper Motions to clean it. And that is that. Boom. So now that we have that, let's talk about some of the herbs. Because, you know, I'm always into herbs. I'm going to talk about some of the herbs and then going forward, I'm going to tell you like which ones I'm actually going to use on this candle. So first thing I'm going to start with, I wrote it down because I can't always remember it all the time, like everything. But the first one I would say would be aloe. That's a good one to use. Another good one would be ginger. That is good for like success and good luck. So of course today I do have some ginger here. I'm gonna go ahead and place that in here. It's also good for sensuality. Let me stop, but it is. Another one would be rosemary. I don't think I personally have, I don't have rosemary, but I do have rosemary oil. And it's surprising I don't have rosemary. I don't know where it is in this kitchen right now, but rosemary is another one. It's a protection herb. It's good for healing and love and mental clarity. So this is another one I'm going to use. Clove is another great one. Everybody got cloves. They making turkeys. It's time for the holiday. Y'all better be making, well, I can't say that I do it for that, but most people use it for ham. I'm vegan, so I don't, yeah, but yeah. Clove is another one that you wanna use. And clove is really, really, really good for your gut if you're talking about your health. But it brings in like prosperity. But the great thing about it is it cleanses negativity and it protects you. So cloves is another one I'm gonna put in my little bowl here for dressing this candle. Another one is cinnamon. There's different types of, well, there's two different ones I know of, which is cassia, which is this one right here, and then Ceylan. That is used for good luck, and if you're using it for health, it's good for blood sugar. So I'm gonna take a few of these here. Fresh cinnamon juice. Another one I don't have, I have it, but I don't know where it is, but it's gonna be an honorable mention. It's going to be patchouli. Patchouli is like a grounding herb. It's good for prosperity, it's good for abundance, and most of all, it calms you. So yeah, I don't have her today, so forgive me. Another honorable mention, which I thought I had, but I don't, would be, it's great for the skin, health-wise. It has antioxidant properties health-wise, but when it comes to like money drawing and things like that, it's good for prosperity and luck. So that honorable mention would be chamomile. So I don't have her. I have a lot of calendula, but I don't have any chamomile. So I was like, oh. One more I would speak on. I don't have it in like loose herb. I have it in powder form. It's called bayberry. If you're taking this as an herb, which I'm about to put this in my tea right now, I highly suggest that you use it. It's good for the stomach health. But it's also good for bringing in money, and it's also good for blessing the home. So I'm just gonna put a little bit in here, not a lot. And that is gonna be like my my herbal part of it. I'm gonna shake this up really good and hope that none of it like gets all messed up in there. But this is what I'm going to use to dress the candle. Another thing I'm gonna use to bless my candle are some oils. Of course, you know we've already got the rosemary, but again, we gotta set some intention. So this one right here is by legendaryconjure.com. I've gotten this beautiful oil off of her Etsy shop. There's a few other ones I purchased from her. They're absolutely amazing, and they absolutely work. They already have some of the herbs in there anyway, but of course, you know, I personally like to put my own in there. On top of it to actually dress the candle as well. So this one is called Mean Green. And then another one I got is from a store in Atlanta, Georgia. You know, I used to live in Atlanta, and I do go there every once in a while because I got friends there, you know. So, but this comes from a place called Modern Mystic, and this joint is called Witch Better Have My Money. Like, blah, blah, blah. But no, this is it. If you guys can see it, it's kind of been used a lot. What I like about this one is it does also have herbs and crystals in it. So that's going to be the oils that I'm going to dress my candle with. And when you're, of course, doing all this and you're burning your candle again, you have to be in the mood for this, okay? So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take a couple drops and put it in the little hose. I'm going to put the drops on here, but hopefully, you know what I'm saying, get them in the holes. You know, not a lot, 4 to 5 drops. And of course, I got my Mean Green here. I shook her up so I can get a little bit of the herb possibly, but that was 4. All right, so there she goes. Yeah. And now I'm going to put a couple drops of the rosemary in there. And see, those holes are so deep, it's kind of just getting in there. 2 drops. I'm not gonna do a lot of rosemary. So I feel like I'm looking at this bad boy and I feel like I see rosemary in here. But yeah, I was like, I don't have rosemary. The legendary got me right. Legendary Conjure got me right. It's already in there probably. So now I'm going to dress it. And there we go. Put the intention in the candle. And now we're going to burn it, okay? So that's the candle. I've given you some honorable mentions and some of the herbs that I've actually used. Let me also talk about some other things that I use. I use something called Call Money. I have some other ones too that are like silver, gold, different things like that. Shout outs to this. If y'all don't know what this is, sorry for your loss. But if you want to know what it is, let me know. But yes, golden all day. Gold everything. But yes, burn you some money candles. Burn you some money incense. Another great thing I have that I don't have in front of me that I also got from this lovely, lovely lady here, which is Legendary Conjurers. I got from her line, I got something called Money Rice. So yes, I always say, you know, we go through things, and even if we don't, you know what I'm saying, we always have goals. And I can honestly say that I am in a place of just growing. So I want that for everybody, you know what I'm saying? And I say that with good intentions. I think a lot of times when you're trying to manifest and you see people manifesting things like that, people can become a little bit jealous or envious. And that's not the type of energy that I would ever want to bring into my life, or would I ever want to be that type of person. You know, I'm all about empowerment. I'm all about positivity. And I'm all about seeing everybody grow. So I hope you guys took some valuable information off this. I can also say with those herbs, you can take baths with those herbs that I've mentioned. You can buy the specific oils, mix it with some coconut oil and put it on your skin. But just as long as you're manifesting it and you feel it as you're putting it on, and you know, you're in that mood to keep that, you know, energy going, I'm gonna say keep going. Don't give up. I thank you guys so much for taking the time out to watch this video. I hope you guys got something great out of it. If you have any questions, definitely shoot me a comment down below. I will put it down on the bottom of the links, the lovely companies that I bought most of these products from. And again, I hope you guys have gotten some value today. With that being said, have a wonderful, wonderful day.